I got a letter. The name on the envelope said Mary. My wife's name. It's ridiculous. Couldn't possibly be true. That's what I keep telling myself. A dead person can't write a letter. Mary died of that damn disease 3 years ago. This is what I'm looking for. It's completely unrelated to what we're streaming today, because we're doing Silent Hill 4. Hello, everyone.
Hello. When are we doing Silent Hill Book of Memories?
What are we doing Downfall?
What's wrong with Book of Memories?
Book of Memories is literally the farthest thing from a Silent Hill game. It's a weird-ass, funky-ass...
It's like a strategy
game. No, it's a Diablo game. Like, it's dead as a looter.
It's Diablo?
It's like an isometric dungeon crawling game.
I thought it was like a tactics game.
No, it's like a Diablo thing. Hello, gamers, I'm back with pizza.
Yes, and B will be returning shortly with Cool Aid.
Actually, I got an interest. How about Shattered Memories? You can play on.
I've played through Shattered Memories already. In fact, that's the only Silent Hill game that I finished. I guess other than PT, technically. So if you're wondering, hey, why the fuck are we starting with Silent Hill 4? That seems kind of weird and out of nowhere. The answer is that Silent Hill 4 is currently the only legally available and easy to get PC version of any of the Silent Hill games. Because for some reason, Konami only did that one. I don't know why. Konami, I don't care if you have to, like, pirate it off of somewhere because you lost your fucking dumbass source code. Just fucking let GOG sell it. I wanna get Silent Hill 2, the actual one, not the fucking Bloober Team bullshit that apparently either you or them are ruining. But regardless, Silent Hill 4 is available to get through GOG. And we'll be starting with this one. I actually don't know how far this is going to go, because there's a very distinct chance that I'll just, like, that this game will just vanish into the ether, or at least, like, this stream will vanish into the ether, depending on how I feel about Silent Hill 4. I've seen and heard good things. I know it's not necessarily, like, this wasn't necessarily made to be a Silent Hill game, but, like, it looks interesting. Hello, Colin.
Hi, Colin. Mm-hmm.
What are the chances of Tommy Wiseau seeing coming?
No.
Not whatsoever.
God anyway, damn it, what's the point?
I can very much tell.
Regardless.
I love it.
I suppose I will also say, because you won't be seeing hide nor hair of us tomorrow or Sunday, Merry Christmas, everybody. Or whatever it is you celebrate. Regardless.
Merry shit scam.
Yeah, Merry Chrysler.
Happy Festivus.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Sam,
happy Starlight. Hey, B, did you do the Starlight event in FF14, by the way?
I did on one of my accounts.
Did you at least do it on your
main? Do it on Camille.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. You get a reindeer.
I know, it's very nice.
Also, the fucking New Year's event is finally giving out a good reward.
Cool.
Very cool. However, enough about that. More about Silent Hill. The stream has been brought to you by the future Silent Hill F by Ryukishio7. Mm-hmm. And I guess Konami, whatever.
Yeah. Oh, goddammit.
Are you going to be playing that one, Orange?
Yes, by the way, you've asked me this like 17 times. We're gonna do Silent Hill F on stream. Yes.
Oh yeah.
By the way, man, are we gonna play X game written and or possibly directed by Ryukishio7?
Yes.
Man, it's really funny how the mission statement of this channel was, we're going to play everything by Ryukishio7 at once right now, and we've only done one.
We've done two. What do you mean?
Rashi.
Oh yeah.
We've done loopers and
Hegarashi. We've done three. We're gonna do four whenever we finish the Fada train.
Hey, Con, you might wanna mute when you're not actually talking, because I can hear distortion coming from your mic every now and then.
I'm on my phone.
Yes, that's why I'm saying mute when not talking, please, so we don't hear distortion, Con. Mm-hmm.
But you can just switch to push to talk. It's not a big deal.
Phone does have push to talk as an option on Discord.
It's weird now, because if you hold it down long enough, it just stays on, but it does exist.
I did not know that.
Hey, big question, who wrote Fata Morgana anyways?
Hmm? Keika Hinata.
Okay.
Did shout out to Keika Hinata, my best friend.
I feel like I've asked this at least a couple times. What else have they written?
They haven't. They've done other, like, offshoot, like, Fada adjacent, like, side stories or, like, own, like, just little stories here and there, but nothing, like, they get. However, their next big project is Project M, which is just a placeholder name for their murder mystery, where you get to be the killer and the detective, and we will probably be playing that on stream. Question mark.
Project M. Yeah, Project M. No, I love Super Smash Brothers.
Indigo Prophecy.
Oh, Jesus fucking Christ, hold on a second.
Uh-oh.
Everything alright?
Sort of.
Merry Christmas, you get no stream.
Yes, I want to change the options. Please and thank you. Oh, boy.
Shout out to Tory Lanez going to jail, bitch! No, you want me to shut up.
He's going to jail?
The rapper who shot Megan Thee Stallion in the foot, motherfucker.
Oh wow!
Wait, why is he in the foot? Why?
Probably because he got his feelings hurt.
Okay,
I'm sorry. Who did he shoot?
Megan Thee Stallion.
I keep wanting to say Megan Thee Stallion because for some reason my brain always puts an R in there.
So. Hold on a second. Add game. Silent Hill 4. Yes. Now playing. Stream to Discord. Okay. It was not automatically picking up the game. Alright, well, you all climb into here. I'm going to make this a little bit quieter because, hoo boy, my eardrums are bleeding.
That sounded like someone trying to play guitar, but they haven't played a guitar before, so they're just kind of strumming randomly.
Mm-hmm. So we're gonna go in normal mode.
What? Only normal? Sounds like a skill issue to me.
You doesn't know how to play Moonlight.
It was 2 years ago that Henry Townsend moved into room 302 of South Ashfield Heights, an apartment building in the medium-sized city of Ashfield. Henry was happy and enjoying his new life.
Was.
Mm-hmm. But 5 days ago, something strange happened. He began to have reoccurring dreams each night. One other thing. He couldn't leave room 302.
Am, you live like this?
I've noticed how hilariously, from the little that I do know, that Silent Hill 4 The Room is incredibly similar to Problem Sleuth.
Another day of living in the feces room.
Oh god, I love it.
Bro, true!
This is a lovely room
of
death.
Problem Sleuth does start with... Oh, this is first person.
I'm sorry, was that a stock-ass scream?
Yeah, probably, a little bit. Yeah. Problem Sleuth does start with Problem Sleuth trapped in his own detective office by, what the fuck is his name? The big guy?
Oh, no, the reason he can't leave his office is because somebody ordered a bust of Ben Stiller from the movie Starsky and Hutch.
Right.
And placed in front of his door.
It was a bust of Ben Stiller.
Truth!
It was one of the other detectives, but it's totally Ben Stiller.
Is this really my room?
Bruh.
You know, if you have to ask yourself that kind of question, probably not.
It's in terrible shape. The air is so heavy. My head hurts. Creepy. It looks like a face. Oh.
Wait a minute. There's more than one room. This game lied to us.
Oh man, I hate it when the goo seeps in through the walls.
And the walls will ooze green slime.
What is it, my goop?
No.
Wait, they always do that. Got anything in there about them potentially spawning dead bodies?
Don't you hate when your neighbors come over to bug you for a cup of sugar?
Yes, sir, I would like to ask, how do you feel about people talking over cutscenes?
It's fine, I can barely hear you guys right now anyway.
Alright, yeah.
Is that guy nutting?
No.
What?
No.
What?
No.
What was that your first assumption?
On my more relevant note, that scared me as a kid, and it still makes me feel a little in the edge.
I mean, it's pretty nasty. I mean, like, just on a level, yeah.
Yeah, you know what? Why didn't we get Rin in here? We needed our scream tuber. Although, at this point, we're already a lot of voices in here.
Yeah. Akira Yamaoka! You love to see
it. We love Akira Yamaoka!
The guy's cool, I've heard.
Known for his work on The Silver Case and No More Heroes 2. And nice. Cyberpunk.
Yeah.
Oh, he's also the producer.
Wait, he worked on Cyberpunk?
Oh, he did Edgerunners. Yeah, he was the sound designer for that.
Nice.
Oh, damn. Mm-hmm.
That explains a fucking lot.
Good job. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. A lot of good things on there.
The Roam.
Where did your love go? Alright, here's our happy-go-lucky protagonist, Henry. He's so full.
I don't like how crisp this man is.
Oh man.
Looks like Eric.
What a dream.
Foreman or
don't worry about it. it's not Foreman though. Actually he kinda does look like Eric Foreman. That is weird.
Yeah, I was gonna say he does look like Foreman a little bit.
A little bit, yeah. Here, I'm gonna go ahead and fucking let me just go ahead and there we go. Nice. And slightly quieter than it normally should be. No, don't do that. I don't want this gamer running at like fucking 17k. Yes.
Dude legit looked like he was about to start talking about Star Wars.
What?
The phone.
Why?
He's something, a big fan of Blup Shitto.
Something I do appreciate Eric. about PS2 era Silent Hill games is that I feel like they genuinely aged pretty well.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
I think it helps that a lot of horror games nowadays go for that PS2 aesthetic.
Mm-hmm.
Do they?
Yeah.
Well,
currently we're kind of in like the PS1 era, but like we're getting some of those like PS2 era type horror games coming out now.
Yeah, the PS1, PS2.
With tank controls!
Let me grab some.
But like, the face modeling on Silent Hill games is always a treat. They look real good. Hello?
What was that? A voice there a sec.
What? The cord's cut.
Alright, shit. Here, let's take a look outside, huh?
Take a gander.
That zombie one you were playing a while ago, Orange?
Oh yeah, what is it, like Dead Estate?
Yeah, there's one.
Which is funny because that actually references Silent Hill 2 and 1 quite a bit, actually.
There's a lady standing at the subway entrance for some reason.
Hotel South Ashfield, restaurant Fuseli. Anything else that's interesting happening around here? That dude's chilling. Alright, so we aren't in the blood and rust dimension anymore, but we are still trapped in our apartment. As you can clearly tell by this door.
Person?
Specifically this bit of the game is first person.
Oh.
5 days ago. That's when I first had that nightmare. I haven't been able to get out of my room since then. The phone doesn't work. The TV doesn't work. I can't even get... Okay. My whole world has suddenly turned insane. My door's chained up. The windows are sealed shut. And on top of that, someone chained this door from the inside. How am I going to get out of here? Don't go out, Walter.
What's going on here?
You're only asking that now after like 5 days of being stuck in here?
Yeah.
That's Eileen Galvin from next door.
hope my luck changes before the party.
There's something fucking insane about that audio mixing. Like, that fucking hit me in the back of my skull. Yeah, there's a funny little note on the ground. Let me pick that shit up. What's this? Mum, why don't you wake up? You put the first letter in your scrapbook. So it is worth noting that apparently if you want the best ending in this game, at some point or another there's going to be a thing where you have to cart a character around. You have to make sure that that character does not die no matter what. This chest could hold a lot of stuff.
Double yep on the escorting.
What was that?
Sounds like a Mr. Orange.
Yes, my father was talking about watching Black Adam or not.
No, don't do it!
I heard it was not great.
Mm-hmm. It's okay.
Oh yeah, that's right, you went and saw it, didn't you?
It's okay.
Tell your dad to go see Avatar 2.
No.
No!
It's okay.
No! Go watch.
I saw Avatar 2. It was fine. I liked it.
It's probably fine.
If there was only one last Airbender, how do they have an Avatar 2?
You say that, but they did literally just announce fucking. They're making a new Avatar series about the next Avatar after Korra.
Yeah, sure, go ahead. That's
which is somehow still happening, because didn't Korra somehow, quote-unquote, break the cycle?
What? I don't know.
That dude's gonna be fucking pissed when he realizes that he only has Korra to look back to.
Bruh!
Through the ritual of the Holy Assumption, he built a world. It exists in a space separate from the world of our Lord. More accurately, it is within, yet without the Lord's world. Unlike the world of
our Lord.
It is a world of extreme flux, unexpected doors or walls, moving floors, odd creatures, a world he can only control. Anyone swallowed up by that world will live there for eternity, undying. They will haunt that realm as a spirit. How can our Lord forgive such an abomination? This part of the book is too damaged to be read. It is important to travel lightly in that world. He who carries too heavy a burden will regret it. That sounds like, hey, only carry what you need.
In Jesus' name, amen. No.
Oh.
Aggressive ass save.
I mean, I'm used to, like, the red paper. I wasn't expecting that. Oh, jeez. Let's see, we got some tissues. And photos. It's a photo of me as a kid, and then when I graduated from high school.
So, what... Alright, going down the list... Orange, what's your personal purgatory space?
Mine?
If you were to die and go to purgatory of sorts, purgatory hell, whatever, this.
I
guess it'd just kind of be my room, if I'm gonna be honest.
Ah, damn.
So wait, are you just saying, like, if you were cursed to live in a single area, like a haunt? Like, if you were forced to haunt an area?
Yeah.
There wasn't a hole here. There is now.
I wonder if I can get out this way.
What did he say?
I wonder if I can get out this way.
Scoobert?
The sewage pipe is broken too. Let's enter the hole!
This hole is made for him after all.
It is funny, because I literally did just reread Amagahara Fault.
That story is so disturbing when you reread it.
I mean, why can't these folks just live normal lives now that they're, like, weird flesh people? Like, you survive it. That's clearly part of it.
I don't think they're really living.
They're making noises.
Yeah, if they're making noises, then they are sentient and alive. It's just, my god, that form is a punishment worse than anything.
Wait, is this the one with the holes?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yes.
Oh,
literally crawling through right now.
Wait, so there's like a form? I thought it was just people getting eaten by a mountain. I didn't
know.
The deal is on the other side of the mountain, there are holes in disturbingly inhuman shapes, and people eventually come out of those holes now matching that shape.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Sorry.
You go through the hole to get to the elevator, or the escalator, that's how it works. I was gonna say, I was wondering if this was actually inspired by House of Leaves, but I'm not even sure if this game was,
I think House of Leaves is newer than this.
I wouldn't be surprised, yeah.
I should probably get House of Leaves.
I should probably actually finish reading it.
I should also do the exact same thing as him.
The problem is that apparently I cannot get it in audio format because it would not be appropriate because of something.
The whole book is like a play on how regular formatting books, like the regular formatting in books works, so like it doesn't really work in audio.
I've heard.
Like, there are parts where there's,
Sam, should I know what you were about to say?
I'm just gonna say, there are parts where there's, like, a footnote, and then the footnote is, like, 12 pages long.
Gotcha.
This is my dream, and you don't even know my name. It's Cynthia.
She looks like a
Pokemon?
That's right.
Looks like Skarl from Niji Sanji.
And a really terrible one, too. I hope I wake up soon.
So you think this is a dream, huh?
Well, if it's not a dream, what is it? Anyway.
I love this music.
Here, but I can't find the exit.
Yamaoka, baby!
Say, will you help me find it? I'm kind of scared all alone. Special favor for you later. It's just a dream, so I might as well have some fun.
I'm just now imagining him with the Leon Plague of Gripes face going, no way, friend.
Bro is flabbergasted.
Would you accept her special favor?
Not really, honestly.
Yes, Khan. Yes.
That's two different energy.
Absolutely. Look at her. My god.
I feel like if I'm gonna do something like that, I want to get to know them first, you know?
I don't need that.
And I feel like if someone's walking up to me and propositioning me for sex, that might not be the person that I'm very interested in. I don't know, for sure.
We don't need to exchange phone numbers.
There are two kinds of people in this world.
A smart fellow and a fart smell.
People with ice cream and people without ice cream.
I was gonna say people who are in it for the dicks and people who are in it for the kicks.
Oh, hey! It appears we're meeting the kicks right now.
Did it make a saber-tooth tiger, a jaguar sound effect?
That is the one thing I forgot about this game. All of the dogs have that stupid jaguar sound effect to them.
Why do you think the Silent Hill series started falling off after 2?
I wouldn't say falling off. 2 wasn't that bad.
I've heard 3 supposed to be good.
3 wasn't that bad.
Yeah, I was about to say 2 is like the one that people say is the best. It has Triangle Man on it.
You mean the strange pyramid thing?
Yeah, the strange red pyramid.
my creature.
So if you're wondering, the reason why this game probably looks very little like how a Silent Hill game should normally look is because originally this wasn't going to be a Silent Hill game.
It's going to be a Resident Evil. Wait, no, that makes no sense.
It was going to be something else. It was going to be like something else entirely before Konami was like, no, slap that shit on there. Silent Hill sells gangbusters.
That's right. It was going to be Rule of Rose Zero.
Oh!
I'm going to assume that's a joke.
That's a joke.
So it was like Bioshock Infinite?
What?
No, Bioshock Infinite was just a victim of Ken Levine being fucking stupid.
I don't even know what you mean by that, Cog.
I mean it was going to be a prior property beforehand, but then it had some other label slapped on it.
I don't think that's what Bioshock Infinite was.
That wasn't it at all, no.
Yeah, Bioshock Infinite was meant to be a Bioshock game.
I thought it was just meant to be Infinite.
No.
And then someone said,
"Go ahead and
put the label on."
You're thinking of a different thing.
Are you sure?
I'm pretty sure I know what you were talking about, but it was not Bioshock Infinite.
There's also that Star Fox game that wasn't originally going to be a Star Fox game.
Wait, Connor, are you thinking of the Mario game? The Doki Doki Panic Mario?
No.
Okay, well, that's what Mario was. The Doki Doki Panic became a Mario.
Hey, Cynthia, you have it. Where'd you go?
Don't worry about it.
Seems like it's been forever.
I swear it, I'm not misremembering.
Unless you can prove it,
it doesn't really matter.
Conley, it doesn't really matter.
I listened to a book that talked about the development of Bioshock Infinite along with other games, and that game was meant to be a Bioshock.
Mm-hmm.
Did it say anything in there about their direction level and what they were going through with the game?
Probably. It's been a bit since I've listened to the book. I think it was like the Jason Schreier books.
Was it Schreier?
I think it was Bloodsweat and Pixels. It seems so
real. Oh, wait, shit, I didn't mean that. Okay, hold on. I want to do some adjustments with the fucking visuals, because it's really blurry for some reason. Sideways movement in first person mode, that is a good one, yes. What kind of color is it? Purple blood? Yeah! Danganronpa, baby! Yeah, turn off the noise effect. That shit is not great looking.
Alright, so it was either Blood, Sweat, and Pixels, or Press Reset, Ruin, and... Why is it not doing the
thing? Okay, this is much better. Alright, cool.
Ruin and Recovery in the video game industry.
It generally seems like the idea was that they wanted Ken Levine to work on an XCOM game, but then he just was so uninterested in running this XCOM project that he was like, yeah, but can I just make another Bioshock? And they were like, okay.
Oh, huh? The furniture has been here since I moved in. Huh? That's weird. Somebody moved it. Sure, I'll straighten it. Oh! Who could have done this?
It's gone.
Glock.
I don't think that's a Glock.
You know what they say? If you don't stop popping, they won't start dropping.
Glocks are very square.
Can I like actually angle? I literally cannot angle this mirror in a way where I can see my face at all.
No.
What a shame.
Probably
that would require them to make an actual working reflection.
Well, no, because here's the thing.
You're one of those things from Mother Dearest.
They use the reflection in a cutscene, just not in game, which is understandable, I suppose. Oh, hey, cool. Well, here, how do I change to my gun? There we go. All right, I am.
What are the chances? Oh wait, no, we're gonna be done with streaming because Christmas season's gonna be over. Damn.
Tremendous is tomorrow, yeah. Well, not Christmas.
What?
Fuck me, is this gonna be the
last?
I was
gonna ask when is the opportunity for Haunting Ground stream?
I mean, well, what is it? So we've got, well, not counting this weekend because that means we're gonna be skipping Sunday, but I still got Monday, Tuesday, like I still got Monday, Wednesday, and Friday next weekend, or next week.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, we can do Haunting Ground then if you want.
Goddamn. This hiatus has been longer than I thought. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Although I guess what is it? Khan, you're not going to be as busy as normal as you have been next Friday, so you should be good. Actually, we could have done fada today. Shit.
Whoop. No, wait. Oh yeah. Whoops.
Whoops.
Whatever.
It's fine.
ETs, ETs. This has been fun. This
Luckily, we're playing a very Christmassy game today.
It's true.
Very appropriate.
I feel so festive right now. Don't you, Henry Townshed? Townshed?
Townshed.
Townshend.
Dashund.
You see, you have permission to do one horror game on Christmas. It's The Nightmare Before Christmas.
Yay!
That's a movie. Well, I'm sure out of time
and,
video
and
game.
And now it's a theme.
It was that era, yeah.
To be fair, if you just play that one section in Kingdom Hearts.
You're basically good, yeah.
Oh, should that yeah. Got back up? Not for much longer, you fucking won't.
Double tap. Double tap.
Beat it till it stays down. Just start yelling, stay down.
Cool. That was a good use of 10 bullets. Alright, back to the iron pipe, baby.
Harry Mason walking through Silent Hill yelling, stay down at monsters as he beats them with a rusty pipe.
Aw, fuck. Worm!
Do you love it, though?
I have mixed feelings about this worm in particular. Anyways, come on! Owie!
He usually only likes worms.
Oh, double points! Worm from the string.
The strand?
No.
What are we doing, Death Stranding?
I don't know. That does not feel like a good game to stream. I'm gonna be real.
I'm gonna say, is that even on the docket?
Like, that'd be a neat little game to do, but also, like, music audio would have to be off at all times because there's no fucking way I can. Because, like, with all the random ass fucking licensed music that plays, like,
I remember watching a little bit of Woolies before I was like, nah, I'm gonna probably play this on my own, and like, the entire first section of that game is, like, muted.
Like, I love Low Roar. Low Roar is great. I don't want to fucking risk losing my goddamn Twitch account just to play Low Roar music. Die!
Listen to Worm! Low Roar.
Worm!
I don't think I can damage...
What is this?
I don't think I can damage this worm in any way that matters.
Because you love it.
I should be able to get to the street this way, but it's a dead end. Oh. Then perhaps I do have to contest further with the worm.
I wonder how much of this worm is actually moving compared to just the texture moving.
Maybe I need to, like, head back or something? I can't really move much further than this. And it doesn't look like the worm is responding too strongly to my attacks and blows. Much to my dismay and chagrin. It's the King Street Line entrance.
We should listen to Worm. Apparently it's a very good book series or podcast or whatever the hell it is.
It's a web serial. I enjoyed it.
Is it like an audio drama or is it like an actual?
Because
I think there's an audiobook version.
Yeah, a bunch of fans made an audiobook version.
Ah.
Which, from my understanding, is pretty good. It's about superheroes.
Is that what it's about?
Yeah. It's about a girl who can control bugs. That's a superpower.
Ooh, that's a good power to have.
I'll be honest, I wasn't expecting that based off of some of the things that I've heard / seen.
Oh, what have you seen? Or just DM me if it's spoilers.
No, I haven't seen any spoilers. Like, I just keep seeing things about Worm and not a lot of, like, actual context about what it is. So hearing it's about a girl with a superpower that lets her control worms just kind of like surprises me a little bit, I suppose. Or
is
bugs.
It bugs or
insects,
worms?
Insects.
It's insects. There's like a passage where she's like, I can control crabs too, but that's not really that useful because I don't. There aren't a lot of crabs around. It's anything with a simple enough brain, basically.
This is so peculiar. Am I supposed to, like... Huh. Like, that hole isn't gonna take me anywhere else that's important. This camera angle is wonderful, by the way. At any rate, what about the boys' room again? Anything else in here?
Let's hear it for the boys.
Let's hear it for the boys. Alright.
Speaking of
Let's
the
hear
boys,
it for Orange's baby.
Stellar
oh,
is...
That again.
We really need to get back to the boys.
We do.
Mm-hmm.
I do not remember Taylor's PRT threat rating off the top of my head.
Mm-hmm. That reminds me, I was going to say, for those who may be up late on Christmas Eve and have nothing to do, I was considering just popping on Glass Onion for those who haven't seen it yet, because that is available
what?
On Netflix now. Yeah, Glass Onion.
I'm around,
it's
Apple
so
Watch.
Good.
Glass Onion is the sequel to Knives Out. Or rather, it is a sequel story. Not necessarily related, but it is a technical follow-up to it.
It's like an anthology, isn't it?
The continued adventures of Benoit Blanc.
Yeah.
I'm looking up
it's
a walkthrough.
It's a completely different mystery, just the same detective, is my understanding.
Am I just supposed to damage the worm?
You killed the dogs?
Yes.
Did you check out the bathrooms?
I did check out the bathrooms.
Check the bathroom, Joel.
Oh!
Did you find it?
No, you just go around the worm.
Oh.
The camera angle made it appear as if the worm was all encompassing, and I had no means of ingress, access, egress.
It would be egress.
All right. Wait.
Egress is how you leave things.
These camera angles sure are a way of doing things.
Oh, this is also a dead end.
It was not egress. Huzzah.
Egrets. Okay, the worm has not been helpful.
Did you find a mannequin?
The what?
A mannequin.
I didn't find a mannequin, no.
Oh wait, did you go around? Okay, yeah, you did go around the worm.
Rare footage of me going around the worm.
Yeah, I'm on a walkthrough right now.
Normally I would embrace the worm, but this game doesn't allow that. You see, I relate to that quite well, being a worm myself.
You're a worm? There's
some very cool superpowers in worm.
I'm a worm on a metaphorical level.
But not on a string.
I'll try heading back up the escalator or something.
There's a guy who's...
Oh, I see what you have to do. You have to get a coin from somewhere. Do you have a coin?
I do not have a coin, no.
Okay, I need to
Well, no,
out...
you have to get the coin from the mannequin.
Oh, well, where's the mannequin?
And you do have a gun, it
mm-hmm.
seems. Head to the bathroom.
The bathroom? Okay.
Yeah, the bathroom.
The male or the female bathroom?
There's a guy in work.
You'll figure out which bathroom it is pretty easily.
There's a guy in Worm whose power is the longer you fight him, the more he turns into a dragon.
Oh, wow.
The other one. I think I saw the mannequin. Yeah, I think it's in the other bathroom.
Oh, okay. I've played so many horror games, like, when I see a mannequin in anything, I just kind of, like, assume that's supposed to be there, and it's just designed as a method of frightening me.
Oh, is it... I did see a mannequin prior in the walkthrough.
There's a girl whose power is when she turns it on, you just forget she exists.
Okay, wait, yeah, there is a mannequin.
That's good when there's a power that you can turn that on okay. and off.
She yeah.
Constant effect.
Okay, so she somehow, has to turn it on. Somehow this guy got, it is actually the other saw, but like.
So yeah, go to the other bathroom.
I went to both bathrooms, yeah.
Yeah, it's not there for some reason.
Go to the left one. Okay, now you see that big circle on the wall?
I have to go back through the hole? Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, some powers in Worm, like, fucking suck. Like, there's this character called Labyrinth, whose power is basically that she can, like, superimpose other realities over the area around her.
Oh, jeez.
But the result is she's in, like, a constant disassociative state. She's never aware of what's going on around her.
I think you need to look through a hole.
Oh!
Well, yeah, he just did that.
Maybe this one? Oh no, nothing happening here right now.
There's a hole behind your desk.
Okay, yeah, you gotta go to the desk.
New hole, I see.
Yeah, so it's the one next to the kitchen.
I love hole. I love hole so much.
Oh wait, is that it?
Oh!
Alright, the rail is back on track.
And you already got the pistol, right?
Yes, I am strapped, as it were. Oh, hi! Oh, hey, Robbie the Rabbit!
Where did I put that damn broom? Oh. There it is.
Robbie? You got something in your mouth there? Oh wait, shit. Who is it? How the fuck is my phone working?
Where did you go? Hurry, save me. If you need a token, there's one here.
Wow, this was really made with fucking...
It appears you can now go back through the hole in the bathroom.
Oh! She's sweeping.
She does. She do be.
Those are some cute finger paintings.
I'm sure there's nothing sinister about the number of handprints. Okay, let me just examine this one more time before I head out. Okay, Robbie still looks like that.
The rabbit does nothing.
It's hole time, baby. Let's go.
Man, you should really get some joint compound for that hole. Can we get some of that mesh stuff?
Oh! Hi-heya! Some kind of mannequin. It's got a coin in its hand. Oh boy, free coin!
You're a free coin.
You can go to Lynch Street now that you have the Lynch Street coin.
Good to know. Let's go to the Lynch Street. Why did I just hear something fall over?
Robert, what does that mean?
No, okay, here's the thing. If you want him to stop doing it, just stop recognizing the bit. In fact, no, here's the thing. You know, if you want to do it, if you want to be extra, when he actually says something positive about you, then acknowledge it because you know because he knows he's doing it right that way. And then whenever you feed him, ring a bell. It helps.
Are you talking about training Robo?
Let's train Robo. Yeah.
This is positive reinforcement.
else. It's like a bee Pavlov trained me whenever she go, whenever they go, orange, and I'll just do whatever the fuck they tell me to do. King Street.
It says head left from the bathrooms.
Oh, here we go. Wait, is this the okay, where?
I'm pretty sure you are at the right area.
Mm-hmm.
You have to use, I think you actually have to go into your inventory and use the coin or something.
Oh yeah, that's probably what I gotta do. Oh yeah, that's right. This inventory in this game is fucking weird. I forgot about that.
Oh, okay, hey, yeah, you want to look directly at the door and then use it.
It's like they're like in front of the thing?
The guy is looking at the door itself.
Like this? The turnstile?
Okay, wait. Stop. Okay.
Oh, did you get the wine bottle?
I did not get the wine bottle.
You're gonna have to find that wine bottle.
Okay!
So is there like an explicit, like, select button?
Well, basically you press, you select whatever item it is in your inventory and then you press X.
Okay, so like, from the video I'm watching, he seems to have like this pill bottle looking thing, a wine bottle, a stick, and as
I
well
imagine
as a bullet.
I missed something.
There's just a wine bottle and you can upgrade the wine bottle after you do something with it.
Where is the wine bottle?
It looks like it just says it's just somewhere either right before you get on the escalator or like right before.
Okay.
Okay, PC is back up and functioning. Give me one sec.
Okay. Also, if you're wondering, yes, this is as weird to control as it looks.
The wine bottle is in your fridge, apparently.
Oh. Bruh. Well, you know what they say, it's hole time, baby. Why does that get you?
You know, sometimes the hole time is the mole time.
I think it's just a process that we have to keep going back for.
Is there like a purpose to the wine bottle? Is it like a weapon?
Yeah, it's a pretty good weapon.
There doesn't need to be a purpose.
It is slightly better than
bottle.
The steel pipe.
It's just always
really?
A wine bottle on you.
I mean, like, I imagine a broke, like, a glass bottle is probably...
And plus, you can also get...
White wine. Yes.
A flask is so much easier to carry around, though.
Oh, you can get those
There's
pills.
Chocolate milk!
Eventually.
Yeah!
Pills. The pills that you keep in the refrigerator.
The wine bottle will break eventually, I think it said.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no, it's pretty easy to break it, yeah. Because it's... once we get back down there, I will be able to tell you very easily how to break it.
Cool beans. I'm gonna put
okay,
that...
So
okay, hold on.
I will mention that the guy in the walkthrough seems to be having issue actually using the coin. I think there might be a sweet spot.
Okay.
He might be a fool.
Okay, fool. Now before we take another field trip to inside the hole, do you have everything? You have your hot chalky milk, you have your wine, you have your Glock, you have your coins.
Hot chalky milk?
Yes.
No, it was in the fridge. It's cold.
Alright, it's hole time!
You have your pill bottles?
Oh,
so, Justin,
like...
to give an idea of what angle the guy is looking at, this is what he's looking at.
Take vengeance upon the worm.
Oh, okay. Sure.
Wait, you can attack the worm?
Yeah, with the bottle.
Attack the worm with the wine bottle.
Oh wow, this guy in the water does. I don't even think he does that. I'm interested what happens.
I'm about to make this Silent Hill game my bitch. Not unlike how John Romero apparently made me his bitch.
Did you even play
Daikatana?
I played 5 minutes of Daikatana, realized this game is bad, and then I stopped.
Congratulations, that's everyone.
Apparently it gets better after, like, the first section. Like, the first section is apparently exceptionally bad.
Is this working right, Nora?
Yeah, glass bottle.
Yeah, you broke the wine bottle. Now you have a far more powerful broken wine bottle.
Okay, so that's the point. Okay, so that's why you're using it. You wanted to break it.
Hold on a second, I've been... Let me just see why... Oh, it's just the Ixion is up. And Bernhilder, okay.
Don't you hate it when your Ixion and Bernhilder are up?
Not that one.
Oh yeah, that's the egg. That's Lion Strait. Mm-hmm.
So are you in like a Discord for these?
Yep. Oh, there we go. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's just the angle.
Yeah, I use Quet Hunts.
Quick!
Oh, hey, friend, how's it going? Oh. Oh, Jesus fucking Christ.
Oh my god, damn.
Oh, boy,
they're like floating.
Why are they moving so fast?
You can't kill them, just run.
Oh, yeah, I had a feeling.
God damn.
I remember hearing about these things in a review of this game. Yeah. My name's Harry.
Also, they just actively damage you by just being near you. So.
Oh god.
Psychic damage.
Save me, Leon!
Bro, I'm trying my damnedest to look at this fucking. It says one on it.
One.
You good?
Yeah, this is what it's called.
Okay.
It's the currency of the new god.
It just costs one plumbus.
Nope. Somebody leave.
Oh.
You joined?
I thought yes, I'm on the PC!
Join. Oh, come on, back.
Ah, okay.
Oh, there's a door over there. Okay. I'm trying my damnedest to get you the fuck out of there, lady, but first, hold on a second. Alright, that makes perfect sense.
You'd think that would- or you'd think you could use the steel pipe. I guess not. It just doesn't seem to imply you could.
I mean, I put away my steel pipe, which, I mean, I suppose that makes sense, I suppose. At any rate.
Alright, I guess we have to get one of those things. We have to
get
one.
Well, you
don't have
one boobless.
Wait, can we use the coins on it?
Actually, yeah, wait, can I use the coins on? Well, no, I'm pretty sure that's just
No,
those are
just, like, subway tokens.
Mm-hmm. It's just, like,
they have
we
no
still
real
have...
cash value.
It's just that we still have the coins, which I'm kind of surprised.
Alright, can you hear me now?
Yeah.
We could hear you before.
I assume that it's just a way to, like, get back in through here. Let's see, that place is locked. That's locked. Oh, okay. There we go.
I was just about to say, yeah, you gotta talk to the car.
Wait, there's a button here. Sure. Looks like the car's door has opened. Oh.
Oh, Jesus.
Tom, please not right into the
microphone.
That was Robo. Like.
Please, no potato that crisps.
That was crispy.
What about potato chips?
Oh, hey, we meet her. There she is.
Not potato crisps.
Sorry. I'm eating Doritos.
We can tell.
Yeah, please not in front of the microphone, Tom.
Oh, hello.
Sorry.
Let's get the fuck out of here, lady. Oh, goddammit, I hate it when the spirits of the damned show up. Not ruining my fucking evening, and get out of here.
Holy fuck, literally me.
You're ruining my evening?
No, the floating spirit part.
Okay, cool, there's no, like, proximity check. Ah!
Get dancing, boy.
Wait, does this have tank controls?
No, this has weird controls.
Oh, worse.
Yeah, I don't know why you thought you could go back.
Is this any better?
I mean, it was fine before, Con. Oh, we heard you do a big Dorito crunch.
We heard you a little too well, Con.
Everything's back on that train.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
There's nothing back here.
Well, it's like, well, when you thrust the spirits of the damned in my general direction, my first response is to run the fuck out of there.
No, fight them.
I know that you get like an item way later in the game that gives you the ability to like stop them, but that shit kind of sucks ass. Oh, I see. Why is it squishy in here?
Would you like a tip?
Give him a minute.
Just get out of the fucking thing. Oh.
Hey! There are numbers written on that vending machine,
I
right?
I know.
You know, we saw it.
Okay.
There's a toy box on one of these cars.
Oh, I see. Okay, that one.
There.
Oh, it has 1,000 written on it. It's locked and I can't open it.
Alright, and then he goes into that door right there.
Okay.
And then he looks at that thing on the right.
Yeah, give him a minute.
There.
Yeah, don't tell me like everything, just you know.
Sorry,
an amount is appreciative. You know, I thought to myself in my head, boy, I sure am glad the spirits of the damned aren't following me. And then apparently, they knew I was thinking that. Where the fuck is this? Okay, hold on a second. Before the spirits of the damned, it's a broken vending machine. Goddamn, okay. That vending machine is also broken. Oh, hey, a hole! Cynthia?
Oh yeah. What? Did you think Cynthia was there?
Oh, well. Alrighty.
Oof.
Let's go back to the house really quickly. So I don't have to drink my chalky milk yet. Markiplier gave that specifically to me.
You got chocolate milk? I've got Dr. Pepper.
Because you're epic.
It's true, I'm very epic. Let's see what other exciting things are going to happen in the house while I was gone. I know I need to be a little bit more sparse with my usage of healing items, because it's after a certain point the house will not automatically heal me.
Mm-hmm.
I make sure to write that down in my notebook every time I return from Subway. That being said, I haven't gone to Subway in over, like, 10 years.
What does your door
say? How to eat freef anymore.
Ow!
He doesn't know how to eat freef anymore.
You had to make sure that you, like, people heard that one, like, goddamn. Like, don't get me wrong,
well,
I know-
My headphones came unplugged. I wasn't sure.
I know which one you're referencing now. I love Finkel Outside the Binkle. Taco Baco.
Okay, but you were low five per second.
Oh, hey, it's the Silent Hill.
Spubby just used to have a really good Sing Shlong Madunga Durg, and it was pretty decent.
Oh,
they
Jesus
added a good
Christ.
Avacombla sauce.
Is this what it's like when we talk about Homestuck?
Yes.
Oh,
This is a reference to.
This is a reference to a podcast nobody's watched except for me, as far as I know.
Oh.
I just think it's funny.
Speaking of, I did see this that I meant to send to you and Con.
Oh, hey, the worm is back! And there's a dog, too!
That's yeah. Teriyaki.
Another worm.
Yo, it's my worm!
Yo,
That is not a worm.
Con, that is absolutely a worm. What else would you call it?
Just me on this. That is not a worm.
Con,
what are you stabbing the thing with? A broken bottle?
Yeah, it's a bottle.
There we go.
It's a giant, uncircumcised penis.
No!
As we all know.
Silent Hill
is about circumcision.
Silent Hill is about circumcision.
Oh, I'm a coming. It's who?
I can't believe it took us this long to make a circumcision joke. How could I forget?
Okay, you know what? This feels like a gun kind of evening.
God, his stance is so silly. It's just, it feels wrong. It's the most non-action guy pose.
I mean, no Silent Hill protagonists are like that.
Oh, yeah, like,
I'm not even sure if you're supposed to stand that way.
Like, Silent Hill protagonists are just normal guys.
Like, have you ever seen how James holds a shotgun? Still, he's like holding it by the barrel.
It's just funny because normally, you know, the animators want to make it look cool, like the poses and whatever the gun shoots. But that is just like the most non-action guy pose I've ever seen.
Because he's not an action guy.
I know, Con, but artistic liberty tends to make it different.
Well, I mean, that's the special nature of Silent Hill.
But look at him use a bottle. It is the most action guy pose.
I don't know. It seems pretty British to me.
What?
Oh, goodness gracious. Maybe we should have less people in here for horror game streams. Ooh, golf club.
Yo, Bioshock reference?
Oh my god.
No. This just means he doesn't have to use a broken bottle for anything as a weapon.
Is the broken bottle still better than the 9-iron?
No idea. It doesn't even seem to list the 9-iron in here.
Well, you know, let's see. We got the same animation? You know what? I think the broken bottle is probably better, I'm gonna be real.
Safest subway in Birmingham.
Oh, blimey, governor.
Yare yare, daze, governor. What the fuck? Oh, it's freaking out.
Okay,
again.
Yeah, no, that's
What was up with that Dutch angle?
Oh, yeah, I'll take a nutrition drink.
Drink 5-hour energy?
What?
It's not a drink. It's more like a drink.
Enter the hole.
I do that every day of my life. Wake up, get ready for work, climb into the hole, exit the hole, expel the blood that's the extra blood that's amassed in my orifices. Go streaming.
You don't want to go into the horrors with extra blood. That's never a good idea.
Well, no, I leave the horror with additional blood is the problem. And that's the bad blood. You don't want the bad blood.
Yeah.
Like the Taylor Swift song.
Yeah, because you know we got bad blood.
I couldn't think of the actual lyrics.
I don't know the song.
Because you know we got bad blood.
Yeah, they got bad blood.
Something.
You know we got bad blood.
That's all I know. I just know the hook.
Mm-hmm. But yeah,
don't even know the full chorus.
But yeah,
are we over Taylor Swift or not? I still don't know.
T.T. Swift.
Are we canceling Taylor Swift?
No.
We're not at the Tasteway chain.
Did Taylor Swift do a bad?
I don't believe.
I think she's just like rich. I think that's the problem.
But do you still think that Beyonce had the greatest album of all time?
Oh my god.
I don't know.
Oh,
I don't actually listen to that much Beyonce.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Do you think that Taylor Swift is good enough that you would let her finish?
What?
Yeah.
What?
Do you have like a dodge at all?
No!
Imagine that you let most people finish.
Time thing?
You might want to, like, maybe try hitting them?
I can't use my chalky milk!
I think it's just a time thing. I think you need to, like,
you are not epic enough.
This guy's got three swings.
Yeah, just time it, and you'll be good.
Oh, okay, that works too.
See, you can't fuck with the favorites and the classics of Broken Wine Bottle. Broken Wine Bottle just knows what it's doing.
Broken wine Bottle is there for you when nobody else is.
Oh, you do got a combat roll.
Broken Wine Bottle loves and respects.
Where was Iron Pipe during Hurricane Katrina?
You see, when you
looked back on the beach and you only saw one set of footprints, that's when Broken Wine Bottle was carrying you.
Beat me to it. I'm pretty sure the only reason I know that story is just because my mom had like a bookmark with it on it.
Oh my god.
Which is also weird because she isn't Christian.
That is weird. I'm pretty sure that's why I know it too, but my mom is Christian, so it makes sense that she'd have that.
What is this damn?
Literally me. What was that? Y'all, I'm pretty sure Orange can reproduce that scream.
Ah!
There you go.
That's definitely me when the Taco Bell hits a little too hard.
Do we eat Taco Bell?
Yes. See,
and
that's
then
the...
he moaned at least this loud.
That's the sound I make when I get Baja Blasted.
Is that your favorite fast food chain?
It is one of.
Because I feel like I've heard you talk about Taco Bell at least more than once.
Have you tried just running past the mall?
No.
I think that it's timed. I think they all do like 3 swings.
Okay, it works sometimes.
You just get fucking mollywop.
Isn't it time to take the damage?
Just
running doesn't
always work is the problem.
Okay, yeah, that does seem to be the case, yeah.
As you can... Oh my fucking god!
Making progress. You're getting closer.
It's caught in a pattern.
Alright, shank.
Average British citizen.
Nutrition drink. Alright, that's fine, I fall forward. No! Shank. Run! Why are there 2 of them?
Alright, here, you know what?
I mean,
go down.
What?
Because if there were only one, then you'd be able to stab them easily.
Okay, that's another swing. They swing 3 times, I'm pretty sure.
Okay, there we go.
Not going well.
Ooh, shit, okay.
They do not want you to speedrun this.
Alright. Oh.
You don't want you to be happy.
Oh my god.
A little banged up, but you made it.
I can't use that here. Jesus fucking Christ. Okay. Well, I'm glad that shit's over with, I think. Is that the spirits of the damned again?
So through this door you can get some more bullets, but there is a ghost.
No, take it! Take the gun, bullets!
And contrary to popular belief, you cannot kill these ghosts.
I know you can't kill the ghosts.
Nope. Just like you can't kill the sins of your past. They'll always haunt you.
No, you can kill the past.
You can kill the past.
We've done it multiple times.
I've confronted many of my sins.
I have received the temptation placard.
Although that priest will never be the same.
Oh, okay. Oh no. Oh no. Oh my god.
I'm gonna mute for this part because this is. Woof, this starts.
Oh my god.
No! Oh!
No, that lady.
That we only knew for like a minute.
A dream, right?
Maria.
I drank too much last night.
Hey, wait, there's a number inscribed on her breast.
Yeah, I was gonna say, is there something carved into her boob?
Yo.
I've
feel like I'm dying.
Nah, you're fine. Don't worry about it. It's a dream, right? You'll be fine.
You'll be fine.
Okay. Don't worry about it.
Those lyrics?
Mm-hmm.
Do you think Henry's going to record everything? Subtle. There's nothing you can do. So
sleep in your only memory. Isn't that how bodies work?
Yeah, you can't do that shit.
Wait, what did you do?
Close one time.
You can't close the eyes easily, yes.
Oh, I guess media lied to me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, we played the mortician's assistant. You gotta, like, glue that in.
Mm-hmm.
Does it, like, stiffen up?
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Wake up in the morning feeling like P. Diddy.
Got my glasses.
I'm gonna hit this
before I leave. Okay, anyways.
I'm surprised you guys
saying,
are like.
Are you
no!
saying you don't brush your teeth with a bottle of Jack?
Whenever the woman.
I leave with my teeth, I am coming. But yes, I love me some Kesha. Let's go.
Aaron's got my.
I saw Kesha in concert once. It was very fun.
Yeah.
I like some of her songs,
Take It Off, and people started throwing clothes on stage. Somebody threw a pair of pants. I don't think any of those people got their clothes back. So I guess somebody just went home pantsless that night.
Hey man, it's like hard rock concerts. It's like hard rock concerts. Some ladies throw their bras and their panties on stage.
I mean, like, you can put your outer clothes on over that. Like, it might not be the most comfortable thing, but you can still cover up. If you throw your pants up there... That's
yeah,
like,
well.
You're just people, exposed.
Do you think people still do that at Rolling Stones concerts? Like, they just see those, like,
roast shit on stage.
They see those, like, men with a fucking combined age of 300 going like, oh, yeah! Yeah!
Probably.
I'm pretty sure people are still doing that at, like, Wayne Newton concerts. Some people just don't have anything going for them.
What happened?
I guarantee you there's
a... There's an ambulance and the police car near the subway entrance. I wonder what happened in the subway. Is it Cynthia?
I did not know that you would actually look out this window.
Hmm?
You didn't?
One of the first things I did was look out the window.
Oh, did you? I missed that then. Like, I thought that it was...
It's a constant thing in the game.
I was just... I thought it was going to be entirely around this room.
Mm-mm.
Well, you see, the outside is like a metaphor for the freedom you don't have.
Oh, it's like a metaphor for the metaphor.
The bird is a metaphor for freedom.
Oh my god.
The dog is a metaphor for racism.
Of course. As we all know, racists have incredibly long tongues, like those dogs that we fought.
Radio. Oh,
look to your left if you want to see an overweight tourist in a Minions t-shirt.
Is this a reference or something?
Ah, what the hell, I've already shot myself and felt like eating Doritos on set.
Oh wait, no, I didn't want to put away the gun.
And Con, no, you only make references, it's not shooting yourself in the foot.
Yeah. It will be once I go ahead and say them with big mouth.
Do I need the chocolate milk at the moment?
Unclear. It just says you can get rid of the coin in the placard, though.
I'm gonna get rid of the 9-iron too. I think glass bottle is top tier at the moment.
Isn't that durability though? Doesn't that have durability?
None of these weapons have durabilities.
Oh, I thought that was something.
They also openly point out that the broken wine bottle is faster than pipe and other pipe-like weapons.
I thought somebody said that the I guess that just meant into the broken form.
Hmm. Oh, the Robbie doll.
What you looking at?
That thing's never gonna move.
Okay.
I'm calling it.
I know how to activate the Easter egg for that.
What?
You have to check in and pop in at least 4 other times.
Okay.
Well, we've already done it twice, so.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, cool. Alright.
Although the cult itself is gone, I'm sure that the spirit of it is still alive. There are too many strange things happening in that town. I'm investigating 2 people, or maybe I should just say just 1. I've just about discovered what's going on. April 8th.
I mean, that's not really Damocon. We didn't know that. As far as I'm aware.
Yeah.
Did it get you guys at least?
No, it didn't happen yet.
Yeah, it hasn't happened yet.
Nothing's happened.
I didn't know this was the thing that could get us.
Poop!
We said we saw it 2 times.
Oh, hey, look, a new hand got added.
This guy seems like somebody that loves his job.
I don't imagine he can even see the hands.
Mm-mm.
But wait, he looked right at it, though.
I thought he just kind of made a shrugging motion. He just made a weird gesture.
From what my friend told me when we went through the game, the hands are only visible to him through that port and through that peephole. Nobody else can see them.
Okay.
This was no point in checking back again. Well... Not much else to do in here right now, I suppose. Let's go check out that hole. The hole's getting bigger. Sure.
In human shape.
What's it kind of human shape?
This hole wasn't made for me, Khan. I'm sorry. How can you just sit there and eat pizza? How can you just sit there and eat pizza? But from Domino's, saving 10% off by using code SILENTSLICE.
Was this a promotional trailer?
People were making a joke about that with the trailer for the fucking Silent Hill 2 remake because it looks so like... It looks too clean and too modern, which is the problem.
I forgot that existed for a minute.
I can't believe that they... Apparently, I believe, from what I've heard, they said on stage that it was going to be a tie-in for the new movie.
Mm-hmm.
The game is a tie-in for the movie.
They did say that.
No, that's the other bad Silent Hill game.
What? I lived here. My heart.
Pretty sure that they said that
New hole.
Remake was going to be the tie-in or going to be the promotional thing.
I actually forgot about the other Silent Hill game. What is the other one that they're making? Not the one that Ryukishi's writing.
Are you town enough?
Was there 3? Was there 2 or 3 new Silent Hill things? I feel like it was 3.
It's something about
it's like Townfall.
Townfall, right. That's it, yeah.
Help! Let me out of here!
Baked in air model.
What do you mean?
I heard weird noises coming from inside.
Oh, hey, that's the guy from Silent Hill 3!
It is!
Richard.
No. Everything looks pretty normal to me. Guy who lives here. What's he like anyway?
I know his name and face, but that's about it.
Well, I'm gonna go call the super.
Yeah, good idea.
Damn it. They can't hear me.
Hey, Robbie. Maybe later. Alright, back. It's hole time, baby. Let's go!
What are your feelings on Robbie the Rabbit?
I like him.
Cool.
I'm exceptionally fond of that one plushie of Robbie that has like a wash erase like marker That like you like put blood all over his mouth. I think that's a really cool little neat little thing.
What was that one from?
Three.
It's a neat horror mascot.
Oh, it has been a long while since I have seen.
Oh, we got fucking bugs. Good thing bugs. I got. Good thing I got bottles.
Oh, they're so hummingbirds. Silly.
Yeah, this is. These enemies are probably the silliest ones out of all Silent Hill.
Who needs bugs?
You can stab him in air.
His precision is unmatched.
Switch over these bastards.
You see, he may not.
When they're on the ground.
He may not.
I like they all fell into the same place.
He may not know how to properly hold a gun, but he sure does goddamn know how to use the bottle.
You have to finish them off.
Amazing form.
They give you bullets.
Excellent suction. Bravo.
Very good, sir.
Are these stock splatter sound effects?
Probably. It's fine.
It sounds like you're going into Lancer's room.
like big games use stock sound effects. Saves money.
Actually, I'll let me stomp.
I mean, yeah, Bone, but it kind of breaks immersion.
It's not.
It's fine.
It's not made with the intent of breaking immersion. It's made as a way to save money. Which honestly, I've always loved the very like cheap feeling that like Silent Hill kind of goes for with a lot of aspects of it. I feel like it kind of adds to the feeling.
Robert, I don't think the average person thinks about whether a sound effect is a stock sound effect.
Mm-hmm.
It's not the Wilhelm scream where I hear it and go, oh, that's the Wilhelm scream.
Like,
if it was the Howie scream, that'd be a lot more noticeable.
Yeah. Which one is the Howie scream?
It sounds like a TIE fighter.
You've definitely...
Oh, the Half-Life 2 fast zombie!
Now there's a couple different screams.
There's weird writing here too. I can't read this writing.
It didn't really sounds like a
the engine's still running and the car door's open. Anything on the car door? Let's see. Other things scattered on the seat. Among the trash is a scrap of paper with something written on it. It's been a while since I came here to Silent Hill. Maybe I'll meet the devil this time. But whenever I come to a cool place like Silent Hill, I always get real thirsty. Jasper Gein?
As we all know, kids love the fucking devil.
There's a memo pad here, too. I'm not sure what that nosy guy meant when he said his home is the orphanage in the middle. The lake is northwest, so the opposite is southeast. The nosy guy said one other thing I don't understand. If you can bring the dug-up key, you bring the dug-up key, you can't go back. Put it away somewhere before you return there. Alright, I got Mr. Gein's memo pad.
It really sounds like a TIE fighter, the Howie scream. I'm pretty sure it's not, but it really sounds like it is.
Hey there, buddy, how's it going?
So you came to investigate this stone, too. There was another guy here before, a real nosy guy. But I was the one who found the stone first. Old days, the natives called it Nakihona. They used it in a ceremony for talking with their dead ancestors. And now those guys are using it too. Call it the Mother Stone. They're just up ahead in that weird building, operating some kind of crazy religious cult. They used to collect orphans.
Hello? We're listening to the thing.
Did things to them.
Oh, sorry, my internet's shitting itself.
Kind of gives you the chills, huh? This stone.
Alright, you have fun, buddy.
There's another... There's another drink near this fence, but that's about it.
Okay.
I feel like this guy could use a pizza.
Time to deliver a pizza ball.
You seem very stressed out.
Pizza ball?
Yeah, just an entire ball Eric Andre of pizza. Yes, it is.
Isn't that a calzone?
No, it was a literal ball of pizza.
It is a ball of pizza, yes.
Trust us on this, Sim. If it's Eric Andre,
it was an Eric Andre thing. I haven't seen that one.
I love the offense in your voice at me even saying the word pizza ball.
What is it?
Like,
what?
Is it like I take a pizza and just smash it into a ball with my hands?
Kinda.
Okay, that makes sense for Eric Andre, yeah.
I also like the only picture, the first video I could find of it is in German. Not the video, but everything else is.
What?
Okay, I think I'm getting the hang of this combat thing.
The pizza ball Scientology?
Okay.
Hold on, I'll be right back.
Oh, you could have lured them in there and killed them that way.
It's fine. Anyways, die!
Don't feel bad. My friend and I didn't know we could do that either.
Die, foul creature. You don't belong in this world. Ow, my bones! Here, fuck it. Fuck you. Ow.
I do like that stomp. That is a powerful stomp. A very assertive stomp.
He has a good stomp. The fuck is on my TV?
I love Dead Space.
Oh!
Hey, Orange, speaking of Dead Space, are you excited for the Dead Space remake?
I have increasingly mixed feelings about the Dead Space remake, mostly because they massacred my boy Isaac Clarke's face.
Wait, is it bad now?
Yeah, they made him look like Adam Sandler.
I'm gonna look this up. I'm not curious what the hell you're talking about.
I hate to say it, but Orange is right. He really does look like Adam Sandler now.
It's such
kind
a
kind of low-key disappointing.
Very distinctly like Far Cry from how he looked in Dead Space 2.
They also gave the same schmutz about how they're gonna go back to the roots of horror and all that jazz.
What the fuck is wrong with his face? Holy shit! That's not Isaac Clarke. Who is that?
Apparently, it's supposed to look a little bit closer to like the voice actor.
I mean, I guess that's kind of respectable, but ugh.
I would rather have him look like Dead Space 2, Isaac Clarke. He's one of my favorite white boys.
Yeah.
Who's your number one favorite white boy?
I don't know.
Robot, you're my favorite one.
I'm not white. I'm not white.
I'm going to give you the white ribbon.
No!
Designating you as white.
Not the white ribbon!
You're one of my people now, Robot.
Jesus fucking Christ.
I can't believe you've unleashed this curse upon someone else.
I feel like if I told you who my favorite white boy within this friend group was, I feel like it would put some pressure on the other white boys to step their game up.
How come now? Oh, hey, it's the orphanage.
Hey, Orange, how many holes do you enter on a daily basis?
You know, at least one. Like I said, you know, I get up for work, I go downstairs, I enter the hole, I exit the hole, I expel the blood, and then I go back to doing my regular stuff.
That's a very nifty routine.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, expel the blood? Is that where you got? Is that what? Is that how staining works?
Well, no. You know, when I go into the hole, my manager Keith, he gives me like 15. I have to be injected with like special funny blood. The funny blood makes it so I can actually occupy that space for any longer than necessary. But unfortunately, not all that blood happens to come out by the time I'm done with my daily activities in the hole. So I have to expel a bunch of extra of it in the blood disposal hole, conveniently located to the left of the actual hole itself.
Coding sounds like it's a lot of work, if that's what you have to do every day.
It's
a lot of blood.
Mm-hmm. What is staining?
Staining is a concept that I created for my D&D campaign.
D&D.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Because the moon bleeds.
Sorry, it's been a while.
You should join in to listen to our sessions, Khan.
Khan's been there a couple of times.
Yeah, but more.
mostly whenever I have free time to go ahead and do so.
I mean, it is on Sundays. It's pretty easy to find free time on Sundays.
Come on, you rabbit.
So, does this Easter egg require looking at it for a prolonged period of time?
I just imagine it's
it
during,
requires
like,
you to look at
I...
it.
Hey, that's a weird ass tie you got there. What the fuck is that?
What is this, Disco Elysium?
It's just a lady.
It's like lady. Is that Mary on his tie?
The Mary, yeah.
Probably.
Actually, no, the tie in Disco Elysium looks better than that.
This man looks like he'd be Christian. He looks well dressed enough.
Hey, Orange, if you had to wear the tie from Disco Elysium for a day, would you?
Sure.
The ugly tie.
I don't give a shit about ties, and I work from home.
Yeah, but it's ugly, though.
Here, can I see what... Can somebody post the tie from Disco Elysium? I'm curious.
The horrific necktie.
Now, if I had to look at Horny Dubone, if I had to look like Horny Dubone for long enough, then that might be a bit of a problem.
Is that Disco Elysium character?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Just I'm calling him a funny name.
Head to the northwest door.
Okay.
God.
That doesn't look that bad.
That's fine.
It's a horrific necktie. It's the horrific necktie.
If you want to look corny, it would work.
I mean, it looks a little gaudy, but I expect more. Oh shit! They respond!
I did very briefly play Disco Elysium. I want to play that again at some point.
Oh, wait. Oh, no. Different location. They did not
respond. I want to
just realize, did we kind of go through the Disco Elysium but we went to Grudge?
Kim is the greatest. That's the deal with Kim.
So I've heard.
Oh, word.
Do you have a map?
Not at the moment, no.
Huh. Seems to imply you should. Oh, yeah, there.
Ah, okay.
It's just not readily accessible from your inventory now.
Wish house. Dang. It's a cool name.
Yeah, it just says there's a northwest exit in this room, and then if you take it, you can get a special thingamadoop.
Is there a northwest passage somewhere in this house?
I don't think it's in the house, but generally, yeah.
Can I get there? Can I get to the Pacific Ocean from this house? Or not the Pacific, the Atlantic Ocean from this house.
This appears to be a northwest end exit of sorts.
I thought you were about to...
Yeah, just run right through. Trying to fight these guys is probably just going to be irritating.
That's fine. I like irritation. Why are you thinking? It's a joke. It's a very mean. Yeah, I was like, what? Yeah, I like irritation. Why do you think I hang out with you guys? Which is a joke. That is a joke. I do not find you irritating. Please don't think that.
I have to try harder.
I am very charming.
That's not what I was thinking.
No, Sim, please, you're my favorite white boy in the group.
I was thinking skin rash irritation.
What?
Why would anyone like that?
That's what I was thinking. And then my mind walked over to a dancing chicken.
That's fine, I like pain.
I don't think... Do you like itchiness?
I like sensations.
You like tastiness. There's a door somewhere on the other end of this place.
If I become afflicted with something, it's like, oh, hey, and that's a different sensation than what I'm used to. This is mildly infuriating. Maybe the next one will be better.
That's why you rub poison ivy all over yourself.
Yes, delicious.
Cheese that
I can't read this writing.
Oh, I think it's on the ground back there.
Yeah. Here we go.
What? There you go.
First ad! It's the first... Hello. It's the first ad kit! And a red hole! It's hole time, baby!
I'm just glad that we got... This game doesn't seem as confusing as the intro part.
Also, hey, there's a lake.
Really quickly, it's 11 o'clock. It's 11 p.m. my time. B-check, how you doing? The answer is you aren't.
Pretty sure B's asleep.
I mean, again,
also you don't need that portable medical kit right now, so you're good.
Mm-hmm. Probably a good thing we did not end up in Paradise Killers or Fada.
I was wondering why B was so quiet.
Oh, B falls asleep without warning at any given point in time.
Oh yeah, Khan's normally here for the streams where B tries to stay awake.
B, look out, it's two men kissing! Look out, look out!
Oh my god, boys love! On screen right now, Pyramid Head!
Where?
On the screen right now!
I can't believe Kaneko fell for it too.
B, I'm deleting your slow damage save data!
You don't have access to that.
I'll find a way!
Oh my god, two girls kissing!
He's in software. He knows how to hack.
OMG,
access the mainframe.
OMG, two large buff muscular men kissing.
Lady Dimitrescu is kissing Pyramid Head right now. I don't know if that would wake her up or not, but I feel like it would shock her.
Most of those men are pretty lethe, to be fair.
Tori isn't getting arrested after all.
Who?
The chick who shot Megan Thee Stallion in the foot.
Oh,
yeah, B mentioned that earlier.
Mm-hmm. Megan T. Hannah.
It didn't get B's attention, though.
Damn. Seriously, though, you shoot someone in the foot, you're
going
to
stop looking! You're not going to find anything in here! Get out!
Or if anything, look harder. Damn, Richard. Open the door, weak man.
You can't see out of peephole on the other side, dumbass.
Yeah, it's
also,
staring
you
right
can very easily see through those, like, all you. There's a not entirely expensive machine you can use. That just looks through peepholes.
What?
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Is that legal?
Probably not, but I mean...
Ethically speaking,
ethics
aren't legal.
I think it is mainly used by cops.
Is it going to do that every single time I check? Oh, okay. You're doing something else now. Shit.
Not on occasion. God, I hate the rabbit.
Oh, okay, on Amazon, Schumer Tech Reverse Peephole Viewer. Great, thanks, Amazon.
Alright, I don't think this
to
is going
to
get us
anywhere.
To be
fair, who does anything in front of their front door?
They're selling, like, long-distance listening devices? What the fuck?
It's spycraft.
Amazon is very dangerous in the wrong hands.
Okay, well, here's the real question. How many of y'all bought those, like, little you know, like, those fucking, like, Scholastic, like, logs you could, like, buy shit from that came in? Did you guys get anything silly from those?
Yeah. I ordered a laser pointer activated light switch once, but it never fucking came.
Wow.
Lame.
Are you sure your parents, like, said they were going to, like, get it for you and they just didn't?
I don't know, man.
It's okay, Roby.
What the fuck did you call me, little bitch?
The answer is hard no. I always got books.
I'm just not remembering. After seeing this stuff that should be illegal on Amazon, I'm just not remembering those mail-to-mail cords that are also known as suicide cords. because they will like blow up or something or catch fire.
Never use mail-to-mail cords.
Apparently the Amazon was also selling, like, the stuff that people were using to, do away with themselves, and, it's not the pleasant type.
Yeah, I can imagine.
And that got into a lot of lawsuits.
Yep. They did that too. That's a lot of blood.
The furries are up here.
No.
Why would furries leave behind blood?
What?
I feel
you know what a furry is?
Yes, I know
come
what a
on,
furry
come
is.
On.
What is a furry?
Oh, not a fucking... Con,
what is a furry? I've got to know what you think a furry is.
Someone who likes to wear the fursuit and somebody who likes to think that they're an animal for
so
a while.
So why would they not bleed?
All right, Con, let's go to the nearest current furry convention and...
No, let's not make that joke. Well, yeah, why did you think that they would not bleed?
I don't understand the question.
Okay, guys.
Am I missing something?
I think we're being a little too negative on the furries. Furries aren't all
fine.
Weird sex cultists. It's fine.
Wait, I wasn't even being negative. I'm just wondering why she thought that they wouldn't bleed.
Yeah, me too.
I think you're just misinterpreting certain things. It's fine.
Maybe?
Just don't worry.
It's goofed and gaffed.
Mm-hmm.
Chuck Testa.
Yeah. People and animals don't bleed unless they get hurt, right?
Yes. People die when they're killed.
Well, yeah. That is true, too.
You know what? People do die when they're killed. That makes all the difference. That, now I understand.
I think you have to do it in rapid succession.
Okay. All right, 4 times in a row.
That many people? Oh. You sure you can handle it? Oh, really? Huh? Oh, no problem. But I better start getting ready soon. I told you, no problem. I'll be there. What? Oh, that. Yeah, you're telling me. I really want to find another place soon. There's just, I don't know, something about this place.
Okay.
I think it needs to be whenever she's not.
I think we may not be at that point yet.
Yeah, I think we're jumping the gun a little bit.
Oh man.
Is he gonna be looking at the fucking door hole again? Okay, Rich is just gone now. Alright.
Robin, I hear you clicking and clacking.
Sorry.
Oh man, we're gonna have a lot of fucking games to juggle when the break is over. Oh god, the spirits of the damned have returned. Hey, child! Oh, this is who I give my chalky milk to.
So see you as a child.
OMG, he's literally me.
What are you doing? You can tell he's a
child. Did he not change his hair? I was gonna say, did he not change his haircut in 30 years? But for dudes, that is not unexpected. Like, that's not that weird for guys.
That nosy guy that was here, he said it too. Something big is gonna happen. Finally, it's gonna happen!
Can you believe it, guys?
Just a week away.
My golly. He needs some help.
So was Sonic 03 the one that started to have more conventional voice acting instead of the really weird voice acting?
I don't know, I think so.
The Silent Hill 1 and 2 had some pretty weird voice acting, didn't it?
I suppose.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, there
you
was
saying
that...
I think he is not a great voice actor?
I mean, he's a bad person.
It's not so much that he's a great voice actor. That the whole way that it was directed was really weird.
Oh!
Because it was Japanese.
Hey, shout out to Lil Uzi Vert Lotus for following.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
Thank you very much for popping in.
Welcome to this bullshit.
Yes, welcome to the Discord classroom where there's 7 people and only one of them's playing a video game.
To be fair, one of them's asleep.
One of them
and
is asleep.
Roku is currently muted for some reason.
Because of click back.
What are you talking about?
Oh yeah.
Ghost.
But yeah, like the other two games, I know that was like Japanese voice directors directing the guy how to speak English.
Well, so it's an interesting bit because from what I understand, a lot of the original voice acting for Silent Hill, they decided how they were going to pick actors based entirely on how they looked rather than how they sounded.
I'm pretty sure that they also, well, they modeled around Guy Sehi, didn't they? Like, they modeled him to look like Jason, to look like him. Not Jason, James. Oh wait, I'm thinking of Resident Evil with the voice actor thing, with the Japanese director telling them how to speak English.
Thank you. Oh, the triple! Ah, stop it. Goddamn.
Ah, so that's why he's horrible.
Ah, you just learned about Guy Suhu, yeah.
I was like, what did he- Oh. It was the 5G.
Yes, the 5G.
I guess it turns out he was crazy after all.
He sure was. I think he was also, like, super Christian, isn't he? Or he doesn't like swearing. Because I know on the CSB podcast, well, actually, at that time, the Super Best Friend podcast, they talked about how he asked them not to swear with him on the podcast.
Watch your profanity.
Oh, careful, it's gonna tank! Okay. Oh, no. Okay, he's gonna move. Shit.
You're doing great dodges, Action Man.
Oh, fuck!
Ooh, nice juke. Oh, I thought you juked that.
No.
It's more like he souped it.
It's like Sonic scream when he falls into the abyss or dies in Sonic Unleashed.
Not now, Ghost of Christmas Breast.
Yo!
Shut
up. Is there a Ghost of Christmas Past?
Well, no, there's the Ghost of Christmas Breast, the Ghost of Christmas
Cock, the
Ghost of Christmas Gender.
The Ghost of it.
The Ghost.
Was the best of times. It was the
Ghost of
Times.
Wait, what about the Ghost of Christmas Pussy?
It had the Burst of Times.
The Ghost of Christmas Breast.
The Burst of Times?
Chowda! Why didn't you? You had burst, Chowder!
Pussy never visits you, Robo.
What?
Whoa!
What? Whoa! 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 Whoa!
What?
Whoa! Whoa! Whoa!
I missed something.
Con, you gotta stop.
Why did you ever have burst?
Well, you know, you gotta.
My internet's breaking. I legitimately.
Don't worry about it.
It's Robo breaking up.
We're breaking. Cause we are never. Oh, you're alive!
No. Holy fuck, he's awake!
Oh, hey, B.
Hi, Bree.
Hello. He's awake. Hello.
Hello, we met the Ghost of Christmas Breast.
Say it again.
Hi, B.
Hi, Azure.
Hi, Azure. First of all, first and foremost, Lanny's group was named B. For me.
You can't stop me. I'm gonna say hi.
I get the first hi. First of all,
well, you see, Azure and B are the ones who have built up the, or B is the one that Azure has built up the most social link with.
I see.
Azure will now die for you.
Hi, Azure. Now you can say hi to Azure. Thank you.
Hi, Azure. I can already say
hi.
Hi
again, Azure.
Well, that was an unallowed hi. You didn't have permission.
Not the authorized hello.
You need to download CS Source to say hi to Azure. I don't need to keep hitting that one. I just need to look into this fucking room. Anyways, how was your nap?
Very good. I got really hot, so I had to go fight to get the AC on for a second.
Did you see your vagina bones, or is that just weird shadow?
I think that's
what?
Just shadow.
What?
You don't not know what that is? That's like the
No, I know exactly what you're talking about, but what the
body.
Fuck are you talking about?
Yeah, it just
no,
looks
no,
like
I know exactly what you're talking about, but what the fuck are you talking about?
Oh, yes, that's right. Alright, hold on a second really quickly. Funny enough, B, while you were passed out, we got a new follower, Little Uzi Vert Lotus.
Yo, let's go. Alright.
Now, wait. Is Little Uzi Vert Lotus a anagram for something?
Little Uzi Vert.
You can never trust these people after the Rindy thing.
That would, to be fair though, that was a sick one.
What if Gunn just what if Gunn just joined our server and was secretly a huge fan all along?
Wait, Gunn did join the server. Gunn is here.
Gasp.
I invited Gunn.
Gunn isn't right here.
Oh, she didn't join the
Are Twitch they followers. Though?
She is.
Wait, did she join the Twitch followers?
Oh god, no, I don't think Gunn fucking watches any of our bullshit.
No, definitely not now.
Maybe if I play Darktide with her, she will.
Now, you also missed me burning Roboot.
Now, B, would you rather be visited by the Ghost of Christmas, Breast, Ghost of Christmas Dick, or Ghost of Christmas Gender?
Ghost of Christmas Gender.
Absolutely, yeah, same.
This is gonna be a very weird animated movie. This is gonna be a very new spin on it.
I am the Ghost of Christmas Gender. Tell me your pronouns and I will give them, and I will give you what you desire.
I mean, that sounds like an easy trade there.
Mm-hmm. The more pronouns you have, the more gifts you get. That's how it works.
The more testosterone or just estrogen.
No, you get. If you have more estrogen, you get visited by the Ghost of Christmas Breast, and if you get too much testosterone, you get visited by the Ghost of Christmas Dick.
Yeah, I forgot what the other two were. That was it.
I already did this one. Oh, okay. I have to.
I'm very curious. Okay.
The kid is just diegetic to the scenery.
Mm-hmm. I'm very curious how muscly the Ghost of Christmas Dick is.
So by that logic, the Ghost of Christmas Pussy would just give you pussy?
No, it's breast, not pussy.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
There is a coffin around here.
Ah, of course. That makes perfect sense. I mean, fundamentally speaking, the Ghost of Christmas Breast is actually gender neutral because we all got breasts.
Yeah, that's what I said. Ghost of Christmas. That's what I'm saying. Ghost of Christmas Pussy is for female.
Yeah.
We didn't say pussy though.
Yeah. On the bottom of the coffin are the numbers 11121.
That is not within the canon.
Wait, how?
Wait, can you pick up can you pick up that Chauvel?
I'm so sorry for the comment earlier, Roboot.
Con, I'm gonna be honest with you, my internet was shitting so badly I could not hear a single thing.
Oof.
Everyone
really
else heard
anything else.
Like, Con, right, everyone else heard it but me.
I didn't hear it.
It looks like you just head back to the...
Head back to the house?
Yeah, just head back to Wish House.
Okay, Wish House it is.
Yo, they call it that because you wish you'll house? Be anywhere else.
The Wish House.
Like that.
I mean, we could do Witch's House on stream. I did buy it.
Yeah. You know, we should just play a bunch of classic RPG horror, RPG Maker horror games.
I mean, we did play. Yeah,
we did Eve.
But... We did play Eve. Yeah. That reminds me. Actually, I signed some of your guys' Steam gifts as the Ghost of Christmas Gender.
Oh, fuck.
Nah, I'm not sure if I sent it to you as the Ghost of Christmas Gender.
The Crooked Man. We need to play the Crooked Man.
The door won't open.
Damn.
Yeah, you can't kill him.
Gave me something really good. I could.
Wish House is in Comic Sans.
Oh my God!
Fortnite Battle Pass.
Oh, okay.
How did I not notice that?
All right, here's the chocolate milk.
He's very thirsty.
Yeah, he's the one you give the chocolate milk to.
I don't like those slurping noises. That's the most uncomfortable thing in this fucking game.
I don't like that it looked like he was about to shove it into his nose.
Take this.
You couldn't even hand it to him.
The technology wasn't that good enough yet.
Just here, take this.
You give the dude a Yahoo, and he gives you a spade in return.
Small spade with a bloody inscription.
That's a Yoo-hoo. Yes.
Blood inscribed spade.
It's an off-brand Yahoo.
Opposite where the lake and house meet, inside the hand holding onto the ground.
Hey, which is the best chocolate milk?
I'm particularly gross. Well, so here's the thing. Yuhu isn't actually chocolate milk is the problem.
That was chocolate drink.
Mm-hmm.
More like a drink?
So Noir, you're more cognizant than me at
southeast.
The moment. So the one at the bottom?
Bottom right.
Bottom right, okay.
Milk was not meant to be drinken by humans.
Shut what? Up, drink
it. It literally was.
No.
Fuck you, I'm drinking it anyways.
Don't drink your calcium, kids. It's gross.
But then how will they strengthen their bones?
Oh, that's why if I pushed bone, every single bone in his body would break.
It all makes sense now!
Stop fucking attacking me. I don't have any treats.
What? You don't? But you just have chocolate milk. What the fuck?
I gave away the chalky milk.
Bad doggies. No blood for you.
You can tell if food or drink is made for a human if I like it or not.
You are not a human.
That's exactly it. If I dislike it, then it's not. Then it is made for a human.
Oh.
That's why chicken is not made for humans.
What the fuck? Why is there another golf club over here?
Oh yeah, there's a 6-iron.
Okay.
You got it.
This ghost of the damned is haunting you with the 9-iron that possibly killed him. I don't know, it's Christmas Eve, I'm losing my mind here.
It's fine. Also, we have like 7 people in this Discord call, and one of them definitely just passed out again.
I'm right here, first of all.
That's surprising.
Hey.
Is he wrong, it though? Is he wrong for assuming?
Let's see. I don't say you're wrong for assuming, but still.
You staying warm where you're at, B?
I am. This is so much better than last year.
Right?
Give it time. It's still early.
It can get worse, says Bone.
It can.
Listen,
complacency will lead to bad things, Paul.
This is not complacency. Last year we did not have a heating system to begin with.
Oh. Did they build up the infrastructure better?
I don't know how the grid is. I can't imagine Abbott did anything special. Oh my god.
That's new.
There's a wasp.
My friend and I never saw that.
Me when I walk into a spider web.
That's how I would sound walking into a spider web.
Apparently there do not seem to be much inherent differences between a 6-iron and a 9-iron other than their ability to drive.
Yeah, the other one is the designated driver after going to the bar.
See, like, it's fine. When we have the orange chest, I just sit by B and then smack him upside the head whenever they fall asleep too much. I would not actually smack you upside the head, I want to clarify.
He would get out the feather.
Feather?
Start tickling the nose.
Listen, B, you said you said if we ever met in person, you would exploit our ticklishness. So it's only fair that we return the favor.
That's fair and valid.
Mm-hmm. What?
Are you particularly ticklish, B?
Really ticklish.
Not like I used to be, but like a little bit. But I don't have like a violent reaction like some people might.
If somebody tickles me, I might bite.
So where do I do it? With a nasty tree?
We'll have to field test this claim at some point.
Ah, here we are.
I still remember this one time where I was passed out on a family member's couch during like some family gathering, and apparently my mouth was wide open because my dad, he looks at my mom and goes, "Look at this." And then he just drips a tiny bit of alcohol down my throat.
Head back out of the door and check the last area.
I then start choking and coughing as I have had just alcohol dripped into my throat during my most vulnerable state. I then start to cough and cough.
So wait, check this area?
Oh, wait, okay, look back.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you see that root over there behind you? That looks like a hand?
Oh, there we go, yep, uh-huh.
That
there
one.
You go. I like other. If you didn't have a spades, this would somehow be impossible.
I mean, it might be deep. We're stuck in there.
This man is not digging.
Got the rusted bloody key. The holder of this coal will wander for eternity. Nice! That's one of my favorite activities.
Wandering for eternity?
Yeah.
Bah! He and his ukulele show.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, wander for all eternity. So we're stuck here.
In the loop.
I'm under the impression you need to head back to the room?
Okay.
Question mark?
Question mark.
Is this game fun?
I don't know, I'm having fun. This is great.
Alright, cool. I wasn't sure yet.
Comforting.
At least it's not Homecoming.
Silent Hill games, PS2 era Silent Hill games are a very distinct aesthetic that I appreciate and cherish with all of my heart.
Oh, okay. That's what they mean. Yeah, just throw the key into your box.
Oh, yeah, then you gotta walk back over to the area. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay. Well.
You know,
like,
what? When is...
Like those are like those that those sound effects. I'll never get tired of hearing like the Silent Hill sound effects.
Yeah, when are we doing the downcoming streams?
We're not gonna do Silent Hill Downpour or Homecoming.
Damn.
What?
I am
doing
so downcoming? Shocked.
No, we're not doing Downcoming.
Mm-mm.
I only want to play the ones that that were made by Team Silent.
Justin will not throw that axe into the abyss.
Coincidentally, it means I actually wouldn't be down for. I would be down for playing like a Siren.
What is Siren?
Siren is one of the other game. Is a game that was made by Team Silent after they left Konami.
I'm going to look this up. I am very curious. Is it good?
It's interesting.
It's really cool and interesting.
I like that. Doesn't mean that it's good though.
Hmm. What'd you say, Pete?
I only remember what, like, was it Siren, like, Blood Curse or something? I can't
yeah,
remember.
It's like,
Siren and Blood Curse. Yeah.
I am seeing Siren 2003 and Siren 2000, Blood Curse 2008.
First one.
Okay, now go back into the hole and go.
You're
get
still
your
drinking that milk?
He is a
He's
thirsty,
really
but he is
it.
Savoring it.
Bro, I wish I had an unlimited source of chocolate milk.
For milk.
Hey man, dude's nursing that shit like a big old beard.
Actually, I should get some chocolate milk after this fucking stream. I think we have milk.
Nice.
My question still stands though. What is the best chocolate milk?
Yes.
The chocolate milk you make yourself, because then you get the right amount of chocolate milk.
I like the local brand.
When you milk it, the cow yourself.
The ones you get from the brown cows.
Thank you!
The fuck?
It's spiritually more chocolate.
No, here, if you're gonna yawn, you're gonna do like, fwa! Like you're an anime character when you go to sleep.
You have to drink it with one hand on your hip and exactly one chug after you get out of a steamy bath.
Mm-hmm.
It is the way.
Life's more fun when you embrace all the anime tropes that you could be doing.
Oh, is Little Uzi Vert still in the stream?
I don't know. Little Uzi, are you in the stream?
Say did something.
You, did you show up, follow, and then leave?
I do not see them.
Wait, can you check the number of followers on the Twitch thing, actually?
Yeah, I mean, it tells you how many people are currently.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. Does it say like it, no? Like, does it say that there's 89 people
followers?
89.
Oh, then he didn't actually follow.
Not, mine
I mean,
says 90.
Refresh.
Okay,
let me refresh.
Okay, yeah, refresh it. Yeah.
Mine says 90.
Okay, so he did actually follow, because like in the past I've had people who will like follow, and then immediately unfollow, which kind of like draws attention to them for some fucking reason. This is at least that's what I assume the methodology behind it is. We've entered into a mysterious home full of
Some people just want to watch the world burn.
Oh, hey! AC still
doesn't have an icon on his Twitch channel. I forgot.
you okay, man? You gonna...
He's tired. He just drank a lot of chalky milk, like an entire 5 gallons of it.
He's feeling logy from all that chalky milk he was necking down.
He's just got some issues that he needs to work with.
Yeah, it's all the chalky milk.
Oh, it's okay, buddy. Somebody just called you a virgin. I'm sure you'll get over it.
There's also a note somewhere on the ground.
Okay.
Near the entrance. Oh, sorry, near a cabinet.
If you're wondering, hey, why did you just run into the wall for a hot minute? That's because it's really, really delayed. Oh, here you go. He found Alyssa yet? How is Walter's progress coming along? Send me your report. Walter.
Alyssa is the demon child, right?
Alyssa is the child from Silent Hill 1 as well. So I guess this is actually kind of like an all-encompassing sequel, because Walter Sullivan was mentioned in Silent Hill 2, and Alyssa is from Silent Hill.
Walter.
I mean, I thought they were all connected, just...
Yeah,
big,
but like
tangentially.
2 is relatively separated from the other ones. The second sign, and God said, offer the blood of the 10 sinners and the white oil, but then release from the bonds of the flesh and gain the powers of heaven from the darkness and void, bring forth the gloom, and gird thyself with despair for the giver of wisdom. The third sign, and God said, return to the source through sin's temptation. Under the watchful eye of the demon, wander alone in the formless chaos. Only then will the form atonements be in alignment. Bro? Okay, cool, I got the source placard.
Oh man, that chalky milk is it's really not a good
one. Oh no, he accidentally chugged 15 pounds of lighter fluid!
Oh no.
Oh shit, that wasn't my chocolate milk, that was my fridge lighter fluid.
Why do you keep lighter fluid in your fridge?
You don't want it to light on fire.
1712.
Bro, are you okay?
17121.
The devil!
Oh, the devil.
I mean, this is a rough way to go out, but the delivery makes it funny for some reason.
Nice more. I'm an Echo reference, sir.
I don't think the devil is a human Echo reference.
Nobody thinks that on fire is.
The police are investigating possible links to the Walter Sullivan case 10 years ago. No, this can't be happening.
Walter. Stop killing people, Walter. It's cringe, Walter.
Tom, what is thumping around?
My mom trying to move her scooter down the hall.
You just got a Razor scooter? Let's go.
No, it's the leg scooter for her knee.
I gotcha.
I don't think it's gonna work for you, Pally. Attendant.
Are you in there, Henry?
Help me! There's something wrong with this room!
Help me.
Help!
Help me,
Let
folks!
Get me out of here!
Is anybody home?
What's going on here?
Clickety clacks, Robert.
Oh, look.
Mm-hmm.
think the super would be able to open a fucking door?
You think?
Like the super doesn't have a fucking screwdriver? Like, just fucking take the doorknob off at some point. Like, it seems
That seems a bit extreme.
See, I choose to believe that the only way that literally nothing can get Harry out. So, not Harry.
Henry.
So, like, if you really, like, imagine just, like, a fucking atomic bomb goes off, and the only thing that's, like, suspended in midair is Henry's room. There's another handprint. That's weird.
Alright, so I guess it's deaths.
There's a picture next to your couch.
Okay, but first, what's going on in here?
Colder in here.
Yeah, what if I look now? Okay, fine.
It's gotta be more than two times.
Where's that? Oh, there's a note over here. Can't look at that. The note's by my desk?
The picture over your couch.
Ah, the picture over my couch. Got this photo from Sunderland, the superintendent. I heard his son and daughter-in-law disappeared in Silent Hill a few years back. James Sunderland's dad is a fucking landlord.
His son is doing very well right now.
I mean, landlords are inherently evil.
It's not in Silent Hill, but it's super.
I mean, not all landlords can be evil, right?
My dad actually has a friend that's a landlord, and
it's okay for him to say bad things about landlords.
I will say, like, there are some horror story tenants out there. There really are. Also, like, my grandma did rent out two apartments around her building, in her building. And there were some people that were taking advantage of her hardcore, and she's in her 80s.
And that child who was there really didn't add into anything last chapter.
That was weird, yeah. I wonder who that was. The devil!
I feel like this is going a bit fast.
Oh yeah, definitely.
The walkthrough I watched was 6 hours. Well, the walkthrough that I had up.
I mean, what is it? Survival horror games generally aren't that long.
Which is fine.
Mm-hmm.
There's also parts of that. Sorry.
I'm fine with these things being shorter. I like short games. Short games are good.
Especially if gives you reason to replay it.
There's also times in that walkthrough where the guy doing the walkthrough seemed confused.
What the fuck? Oh.
Just the game.
I'm not gonna lie, that hit my ear in a way that made me.
Yeah, me too.
There's something about the sound design in this game that just hits you the wrong way a little bit.
Yeah, it hit me in the back of my brain. Where it's like, is that someone calling me from downstairs?
That's the Silent Hill ASMR.
Get the Hydra's back.
Silent Hill ASMR.
You know what? I will, Phil.
Horrifying nurse monster softly stabs you in your sleep.
No.
ASMR.
Goofy looks like ASMR. Kids are writing. I'm being watched from another room.
ASMR, you're being hunted by
a little worm.
German.
What a funny little worm.
Those are actually leeches.
Will you love him though,
Orange? It's close to a worm.
I'll love anybody if they're a worm. It's fine.
What if they were in your brain? What if they were a worm in your brain?
Then you'd be waiting for the worm.
Waiting.
Wait,
Noir gets it.
Then I guess you are the worm.
To get to the surveillance room in the middle of this complex, you have to use the corpse disposal chutes in the cells. However, on the first and second floors, these cells are locked. That's it. That's so the kids wouldn't discover them. So you have to get to the first floor from one of the cells on the third floor. I know how to do it, but it's really a pain. Also, the light only works on the third floor. Oh, so we're on the third floor because the light's actually working here. Anyways, it's hole time, baby!
I wonder if this will become, more horrifying over time.
It gets more questionable over time.
Radio. What's going on with that radio?
Radio? Who needs a radio?
That was kind of funny to think that at the time this was... Whoa! Sorry, there was a buzzing there for a second. Oh. She's loving whatever she's looking...
Huh?
She's watching Two and a Half Men.
She's just vacant now.
Hey, you see me?
I don't think so. Oh. See someone over there?
Okay, don't turn into that one manga.
Anyway, it is kind of funny.
Which one?
Funny thing.
I forgot the name of it, but it starts with the Peeping Tom dude who...
Doesn't it?
Hi, Kinvale. It's Poppin'.
Oh, hello, Kinvale. It is kind of funny to think that at the time this came out, that type of TV was modern.
Scrap of red paper in here. Oh, wait, shit. Investigating the man's murder that took place 7 years ago, in which 10 people were killed in 10 days. They were killed in a variety of ways, but the one thing they had in common was that each corpse had the following numbers in order of their deaths carved on them. The name of the killer was carved in as well. His name was Walter Sullivan, April 4th.
Walter.
Cool stuff that came out in 2004. Charlie Murphy first appears on the Chappelle Show. Jetix comes out.
Oh, cool.
Nice.
Sex in the City ends.
Oh, hey, Mirinda, how's it going? Yeah, House of Fata Morgana's great.
Yeah.
Yeah, check that shit out. Yeah, hey, Mirinda.
And Katon
Vale.
Hi.
Oh, damn, everybody's here tonight.
Mm-hmm.
The controversial episode See Me, Feel Me, Know Me of the Powerpuff Girls is banned in the U.S. due to mild religious imagery.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But
yeah,
Wasn't the gnome written to be played by Jack Black, though?
No, but he does sound a lot like him.
Yeah, okay.
Friends stops and Joey debuts.
Oh yeah, House and Fata Morgana was fantastic. We finished the base game of it and all of the VODs are up on my YouTube now. We are doing a prequel series, which by the way, you don't want to watch that one. If you haven't seen the regular Fata Morgana, you probably want to do regular Fata Morgana first because it spoils some things.
It's fantastic.
Frasier ends. Jimmy Fallon leaves Saturday Night Live on its last for the season finale, hosted by Mary Kate and Ashley Olsen, with musical performance by Jaquan.
Oh, not these fucking things again. Ow!
Tech TV merges with G4 to become G4 Tech TV.
Oh, neat. I love
Less
G4.
Than a year later, it becomes G4 again.
Can I actually Clone Cold Session of all the warriors here today?
Oh yeah, Clone Cold Session. I knew there was one more.
Foster's comes out.
Wait, I'm for Imaginary Friends?
Another TV show, Foster's.
Like Foster yeah,
Foster's
Home
for Imaginary Friends.
I remember that
show. There's another TV show called Foster's.
Lost. The original Dora the Explorer retires. I didn't know there was more than one.
Oh yeah, I think one of them quit because her pay was bad or something. I could be wrong about that.
You're a Lost defense? I heard that Lost ended horribly.
It was horrible. Things didn't make a lot of sense, and they weren't very good.
Was the show itself good until the end?
Debatable, yeah.
Lost?
Yeah. Dallas somehow airs a third TV movie, Dallas Reunion, The Return to South Fork.
You know, I bet if I watched Lost right now, I probably would not mind the ending just because of how, like, much people have said it's bad. I feel like if I
Gray
go
Delisle.
In...
Gray Delisle, fresh off of being the best character in Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends, comes out with a hot new show, Hi Hi Puffy Amiyumi.
Oh, yeah!
Oh, yeah, Puffy Amiyumi.
That show was so much of my childhood.
I can't believe... That is one of those things that you forget until somebody brings it back up, I feel.
I watched so much of that show. It's one of the reasons why I wanted to learn more about Japanese culture.
Other big-name shows that came out include Drake and Josh.
Hey!
The L Word. Booba.
Lesbians.
Dave the Barbarian.
Oh,
yes!
That's a name I haven't
heard
in a while.
I remember that one.
Power Rangers Dino Thunder.
I remember Dino Thunder.
That was a fun one. I vaguely
to
remember
watch Dino
Thunder.
Witch Hunter Robin appears on Adult Swim.
Woo! Don't know what that is.
Kick-ass
it is
anime.
An anime. It's about a witch. It's about a lady named Robin who hunts witches.
It's really stellar animation-wise.
Pimp My Ride.
I have honestly never seen that.
Oh, boy.
Good.
This does
You're not
look...
missing anything.
This does look like a early 2000 anime, Witch Hunter Robin.
Deadwood.
It sounds familiar.
It is a famous western on HBO. He's a phantom.
Phantom. He's just 14 when his parents built a very strange machine that was designed to view a world unseen.
He's gonna get to know because he's Danny Phantom.
A lot of shit happened in 2014.
Wolf's Rain lands at Adult Swim.
What
also
did?
Awesome.
A Wolf's Rain. Megas XLR.
Megas XLR!
Yeah!
Then James
Big
giant robots!
Somehow Case Closed only arrives at Adult Swim now? I thought that was like one of their original things.
Yeah,
they
before
just had
that
come
there was
out.
This Lupin.
Lupin is a son.
Phil of the Future.
Oh, that was a good one.
I remember being sick one time. And
unfortunately, the Fox Box still existed, and we're premiering Winx Club.
That's... I will admit, I actually did get introduced to Winx through the 4Kids dub.
I figured there would be no other way to get introduced to it.
Stargate Atlantis. Justice League Unlimited.
Yeah!
Hell yeah!
Oh, I'm
I should
stupid.
Watch SG-1.
I'm stupid. That's a spiral staircase. I was just walking in a straight fucking line.
So, like, what is Stargate about? Is it just, like, we figured out how to make the Stargate go to different
basically,
places?
Basically, it was based on this movie called Stargate by Roland
I've
Emmerich.
I've seen
where
the movie.
Opened,
is it just, like,
portal?
They figured out how to make the Stargate go other places than the weird Egypt planet?
As far as I know.
Are there aliens in that?
Yeah.
Atomic Betty.
Oh god, that's a fucking blast from the past.
Ooh, I vaguely remember that one.
Lazy Town comes to Nick Jr.
Hell yeah, Lazy Town.
I remember that. The puppets creeped me out.
Brandy and Mr. Whiskers.
Oh wow, I liked a lot of that, yeah.
Oh shit!
The Batman!
What the fuck is these? The brainstems?
Oh, those are the toadstools.
Of course.
They're apparently very easy to avoid.
Say Batman?
Batman.
No, the Batman.
The Batman.
The one that came from
the
Batman, WB.
Yeah,
the
Ned's
one that had
Joker
with...
survival guide.
Yeah, I fucking love
that. That was a good one.
The Dog Whisperer with Caesar Milan.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
That is something a parent would watch, yeah.
There's a note over there. Hold on. Henry, come on.
That's Declassified was awesome TV, though.
Also, with
really helpful tips.
I mean, what is it? Fucking Darian Norris played the goddamn janitor, and Darian Norris is a fucking fantastic actor.
Desperate Housewives.
Not interested.
How desperate can those housewives
be? The short-lived Drew Carey's green screen show.
Oh, that reminds me. Who's excited for Hills Island, everybody?
Drew Carey in this show.
The Backyardigans.
I remember those.
That one's still iconic. Hearing it.
PBS Kids Go starts with flagship titles like Maya and Miguel and unfortunate and less than interesting Arthur spinoff Postcards from Buster.
I remember Postcards from Buster. That was the weird half live action one.
I tried to watch it as a kid. I wasn't interested.
Battlestar.
I did not like it as much as Arthur. I remember that much.
Drawn Together.
I will admit I've seen all of the first season.
Probably the biggest show on Adult Swim, Perfect Hair Forever.
Yes!
I've never
heard of
Perfect Hair Forever was an incredibly lousy and just kind of stale anime. Like, it was just trying to parody bad anime.
This thing.
No. Tom Goes to the Mayor.
Con, I would see this come up and I would turn off the TV. That thing fucking made me uncomfortable.
Tom Goes to the Mayor?
No, Perfect Hair Forever.
Alrighty then. It is midnight. So I think that we'll be ending the stream for right now, so you'll have to talk about 2004 media later.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Will you play this again?
Wait. Yeah, actually, I want to play more of this. This is fun.
Alright, we have our emergency game, if not casual game. I don't know, because don't we have other stuff also?
We have to finish.
Yes.
We have to finish Paradise Killers, we have to finish this, and we have to finish 428.
Well, these are
428 for a minute.
I remembered it. It's never left my mind.
Oh, man.
We will get around to finishing our scramble in Shibuya.
Alrighty.
My memory is very selective sometimes.
That's right. Return next week to find, or return next time to find out which shows have been canceled in 2004.
When? Wait, just Dan or Ange, boy. Mm-hmm. When are we getting back to Fata Morgana? The other Fata Morgana.
Requiem for Innocence will probably be resuming next Friday?
Maybe.
Maybe.
We hope.
I think
what's next Friday?
Next Friday will be is going to be the day before New Year's Eve.
Okay.
So the answer is affirmed.
We're all
going to
be
maybe.
Very busy on the 30th,
depending on life and health.
Mm-hmm. Other than that, true. I'll probably be on. Well, obviously Sunday we're going to be off. For Sunday we're going to be off because that's Christmas Day, of course.
Word.
Mm-hmm. Monday, Wednesday, I guess, Monday and Wednesday will kind of, like, vary through doing this and Paradise Killers, because we gotta finish that too, shit.
They gotta finish killing all that paradise.
So true. Alright, that'll be it. Good night, everybody. I hope you have a good one.
Good night.
Bye-bye! Good night.
Good night.